Good morning. We're starting off our day with more snow in the valley. Unfortunately, we're adding another couple of inches of snow or more to some parts of the valley here this morning and throughout your Wednesday. We'll talk about snow totals in just a moment. But looking out on our Storm Team SkyCam network view here in Fargo, we're looking over toward the west. We've had a round of some decent snowfall coming down in the last hour or so. That band is moving northward, so our visibility is improving a little bit. But you can see that we're dealing with that snow still right now. And on the road surface, you could see on the interstate that we've got some snow that's affecting us, or rather some snow on the interstate and on some of those lanes here to start off the day. So again, crews are going to be working to keep up with us here today. Let's take a look at our current headlines. We do have that winter weather advisory in effect for the daytime hours here for Fargo, points east and points south of there, essentially up to the northwest and over by the Grand Forks area. We're looking at still that snow chance, but maybe not quite as much snow. And then of course that winter storm warning in red here in Minneapolis, St. Paul, right in the heart of it. So if you've got some travel plans heading in that direction, definitely want to check ahead before you hit the road here. We're looking at your radar and satellite loop coming in out of the south. That's where we've been seeing that snow movement. And you can see on the last couple of frames of the loop, that heavier band of snow starting to lift north of the metro, heading northward toward the Highway 2 corridor here this morning. And there's more where that came from as we expand the view. This is a big area of snow. They're getting hit pretty hard in Minneapolis right now, stretching especially back down towards Sioux Falls. Overall, the system's going to move to the northeast, and we'll just be on the northern edge of it. So we'll see some chances at a couple of inches of snow or more, but the heaviest stuff will be more down to the south. So here's a look at our winds. Not very strong with this system. That's a good thing. If we're going to get some snow, we definitely don't want to see the wind along with it, though there are some speeds into the teens. Visibility down to less than a mile at the airport in Fargo and other places where we're seeing that visibility on the lower end here in the Southern Valley where the snow has been falling. Much colder to the north, but that warmer air is working northward too, so our temperatures will continue to climb. In fact, we're already starting to see that in the Northern Valley. It's currently 13 degrees in Fargo and 7 in Grand Forks. You'll notice a big difference in those temperatures with wind chills that are colder north, below zero there. And in the south, we do have a few below zero wind chills thanks to some stronger winds too. So here's a look at our hour by hour planner. That snow lifting northward here today. Basically, everybody has a shot at some snow. It's just that the better bet for significant accumulations will be down to the southeast. So heading into the noon hour, you can see Fargo right in the heart of that current round of snow. And then into the 3 o'clock hour, more snow showers ongoing with breaks in between. So some of us, it'll be an all day event. Some we might get a couple of hours of a break or maybe even more in some spots. And temperatures into the teens to some low 20s. So a huge difference as far as temperatures are concerned. We just have to put up with this snow. Your evening commute's going to be a snowy one, and then heading into tonight, that eventually starts to wind down. We see a few lingering snow showers into the overnight hours, but by 7 o'clock tomorrow, it's looking a lot quieter. Temperatures in the single digits to some teens to start off your day Thursday, and we should get a break from the snow on Thursday to do some cleanup here from this latest round. So here's a look at our snowfall potential. We've upped things a little bit for parts of the valley out to the northwest, maybe about an inch of snow in Devil's Lake, Grand Forks kind of in that 2 to 3 inch range, and then Fargo and other places to the south and east. That's where we could see some bands set up of 3 to 5 inches of snow and more widespread areas of 5+ inches of snow in places like Grant County down toward Traverse County as well. So bottom line, you're going to expect to have more snow the farther southeast you happen to be. So this will happen over the daytime period and into tonight. So it'll be a gradual buildup. Hopefully we'll be able to keep up with it in those areas. And a break Thursday, Friday and into Saturday, some more chances for snow. And we stay mild through the weekend before cooling down next week.
Okay, thank you, Lisa.
If you're looking for a way to get crafty and avoid the snow, then stick around. Just ahead, we'll tell you about this weekend's Craft Fest.